What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It is officially Easter egg hunting day for Black Ops Cold War and the brand new Firebase Z map. We got an update late last night for Warzone fixing the Stim glitch and adding a couple of different things. And we got the addition of the CDL skins added here today. And in this video, I want to talk about everything that happened over the past 12 hours. First things first, let's talk about what you got a chance to see on the thumbnail. That is the brand new Zombie Dozer bundle. I think that this skin looks absolutely fantastic. It's our very first skin for Bulldozer, and they knocked it out of the park. The finisher in this pack is absolutely brutal, and I love the color scheme on the MAC-10 and the XM4. If you plan on picking up this pack, or any other pack in the shop for that matter, please consider using my creator code, which is PRESTIGE in all caps. Doing so goes directly to supporting me and my family. I thank you all so much for the continued support. I've always been a sucker for those characters with ballistic face masks, and it's no different here with Bulldozer. I've loved the look ever since I first saw a character with it back in Modern Warfare 3 multiplayer. Anyway, I wanted to talk about something else that came to the shop, but it's not available for COD points. Similar to last year with Modern Warfare 2019, we also got CDL packs that were just added today. There are 12 in total, and each pack costs $9.99 plus tax. The 12 teams that are being supported this year are the Toronto Ultra, Seattle Surge, Paris Legion, London Royal Ravens, Minnesota Rocker, New York Subliners, Los Angeles Thieves, Los Angeles Gorillas, Florida Mutineers, Atlanta FaZe, Optic Chicago, and Dallas Empire. Each $10 pack will consist of two operator skins, one for use on the Warsaw side and one for use on the NATO side, a weapon camo, a watch, a weapon charm that looks like a shoe, a calling card, emblem, and a sticker that can be applied to your weapons. Unfortunately, the only thing you're unable to preview from these packs in-game are the camouflage patterns themselves. I'm gonna go ahead and bite the bullet and show you guys what these camouflage patterns look like. And just like I said last year, I don't think the intention of these packs were for every single player to buy every single one of them. It's intended to be put out there for people that want to support their favorite team or represent their favorite team in game. I don't recommend, and I never recommend, anybody buy every single one of these packs. That's not the intention. I just specifically wanted to show you what the camouflage looked like because you cannot preview them in game. I was really hoping they go all out this year and actually give us the opportunity to have some sort of animated camo or do something of the sort like that, but unfortunately it doesn't seem to be the case. It's the same exact design, just a different color to represent the team that obviously you pick the pack up for. The watches are also the same exact design, it just changes the face of the watch and the color scheme around it. The same thing can be said for the weapon charm. The shoe will actually remain the same, but the color scheme will change depending on what team you picked up the pack for. Other than that, there is nothing more to these packs. I hope that seeing them visually here on YouTube in 4K was enough to help you all make a decision on whether or not you wanted to pick up a certain bundle and support a certain team. Moving on forward, let's talk about the update that came out last night for Warzone, and of course the update that came this morning for Black Ops Cold War with the addition of the Easter egg for Firebase Z. Let's start with Warzone. Even though there was a patch that came out last night, there are still some new issues that have been found because of this patch. So first things first, the biggest issue was the infinite Stim glitch, allowing people to continuously heal outside of the gas and basically win games absolutely free for doing nothing. This has now been fixed for the fifth time. I don't know how many more times it's going to take until they finally decide to just remove the Stim altogether, but this is now fixed. They've also adjusted the match bonus and kill XP award for Kingslayer mode to be more in line with the Verdansk BR, and they're trying to normalize the XP rewards across various game modes in order to make this a little bit better for all players. They've adjusted the timing of ammo replenishments during empty reloads for the Black Ops Cold War weaponry. Certain operator missions for Stitch should now track as intended, so for those of you playing Black Ops Cold War multiplayer being forced to go into Warzone in order to get these challenges done, they should be working properly. They fixed some weapon glitches and animation issues, visual bugs for specific weapons within the armory. They've also fixed some visual issues with weapon level not properly showing for what your actual level is versus what it's showing in the barracks menu. Now, because of this update that came through for Warzone, there has been a weird issue where hit markers are not appearing. And as you could imagine, hit markers are a very important piece of feedback that the player needs in order to know that they're doing damage to an enemy. When you're not receiving hit markers, this can cause you to lose gunfights, and it can also cause you to really not be sure in the shot that you're taking and try to reposition and or actually miss shots altogether. The good news is they already know that this is an issue. They're looking into it right now, and there should be a fix relatively soon. So if you run into this, well, press F because that sucks, but just know that they are already looking into this. Another issue that has appeared is people not being able to select their operators. When you try to go to the operators menu, sometimes it will just pop back and it won't allow you to actually go there, which means you can't customize your character right now. And that is a pretty big issue, especially when we consider there's a lot of items in the shop that people recently purchased and they want to be able to use those items in the game. Good thing is they know about this issue as well, and they did let us know that there will be updates as soon as they're available. Moving on over to the Black Ops Cold War update. Of course, we all know that double XP was activated in Cold War and Warzone, and it's going to be available until February 8th, and that's available on all platforms. Prestige icons were updated in the Prestige shop, and we talked about that a couple of days ago. They, of course, added the ability to do the Easter egg in Firebase Z, which was recently solved just a couple of hours ago. The HARP was repaired, so now it's going to properly display when a friendly HARP is active, regardless of a UAV being active or not. And they also fixed the jammer field upgrade glitch, where people would just completely disappear if they even came in contact with any type of jammer that's on the map. So the HARP should work properly, and those Doritos should appear as intended. They've also fixed some issues with stability. So people have been seeing over the past couple of hours that the game has been kind of glitching and crashing. They fixed crashes that would occur as the train exited the map on Express. They fixed crashes that could occur while doing split screen. They also fixed crashes related to zombies by purchasing Tombstone, getting the Napalm Strike, calling in an artillery, and trying to exfil in general. So lots of stability fixes overall, and this should allow people to continue playing the game as intended. Interestingly, they did make a small movement change this time around. They added a small speed penalty and jump height penalty after landing from a jump. They're going to continue to monitor this change in a live environment and make further tuning changes as they need to. Now, one thing that we have been seeing a lot of in Black Ops Cold War is bunny hopping, jumping around corners, jumping in general. This has been happening in Call of Duty for a decade now, and I don't see this changing anytime soon, but it is kind of weird that they made this small movement change in the game. Not something I expected to see. The custom games playlist ended up getting an update, adding gunfights, so now we can experience and play those maps in private matches. A CDL Pro custom game list was added as well, including Hardpoint, Search and Destroy, Control, and it all has preset CDL classes and competitive settings, so if you wanted to go play a little more competitively, you could do that. And there were some UI error issues that were fixed by people trying to save their own custom games in the custom games settings. Now, the final thing I want to bring up, just like Warzone and the missing hit markers, there was an issue that arose because of this update. That issue is players are appearing invisible sometimes in multiplayer games. Obviously, this is a bad thing, and I don't need to tell you why, but it just seems to be happening once in a blue moon. I haven't had this happen to me personally, but I've seen plenty of videos online of it happening to other people. It's even happened to Pamage, which I think is kind of crazy. But one other thing I noticed is it seems to be happening more so on Express than other maps. I don't entirely know what the team plans on doing. I went and checked the Trello board where they talk about known issues, and I didn't actually see this issue there, so maybe it's really far and few in between and it's not affecting a lot of players, but I know that the team is already aware of this. I'm sure that they are going to be fixing it as soon as they possibly can. Finally, to end off this video, I wanted to let y'all know that there was a small Season 2 teaser that ended up popping up with the Warzone update. This teaser comes in the form of a cutscene, and I want to go ahead and play it right now for you, and I will be back in just a moment.
Kill the rest. Adler is mine. See you in hell.
So, what the heck is gonna happen to Adler? An eye for an eye? Is he gonna lose an eye? Stitch actually has him hostage right now. I have no idea what to expect. But let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video here today, do me a favor and drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. All right, folks, I'll catch you on the next one.
Peace.